calcium is not for flowering video really stirred up a lot of controversy. And in this video, we're going to go through as many questions as possible until my daughter doesn't want me to answer any more questions. If you haven't checked out our monthly membership, I highly recommend to do so. Just for $2.99, your questions get sent to the top for quick replies. I'm asking for a little more support to build up my war chest so that I can continue to keep giving you open and honest reviews, and we can further defend our right for free speech. Thank you so much, everyone. So if you get a chance to check that out, please go ahead and do so. All right, so let's go ahead and get into it. Okay, so first question, does this pertain to autoflowers? I would say 100%, right? The thing about autoflowers, I think, are a little bit tricky, though. I've seen some of them just stay squatty, and then 5, 6, 7 weeks into growing, they just take off. You know, so I was thinking the autoflower was going to stay shorter, but they ended up not staying shorter. And then while they're already flowering, they end up shooting straight up. In that situation, as the plant's growing, for me personally, and if I was thoughtful enough and I wasn't too busy and my life was into growing, I would probably brew up your tea and assist the plant in its growing process, right? If it's shooting up, what is it going to need? It's going to need some immobile and some mobile nutrients. It's definitely going to need some additional calcium, nitrogen, magnesium, phosphorus, iron, sulfur. And I think if I brewed up a tea while the plant was growing really quickly, I think I would go through less issues and get better results with those autoflower plants. And again, I'm just growing with the plant, right? I'm assisting it as it is doing something. And through daily observations, I'm able to make small adjustments. All right, next question. So this is contraindicated to absolutely everything I've ever heard. All right, and why is it with all the hype? So you got to think about it, right? What is some of the problems that you see immediately from when the plants are growing from the very beginning? You're going to see some phosphorus, some nitrogen. I don't want to call it nitrogen. You're going to see some phosphorus, some magnesium deficiencies because it might yellow back. You might see, if the plant is staying short, you might see some nitrogen deficiencies. And you kind of have to think about it, right? This industry is creating products to solve your worry as soon as possible. And calcium, magnesium is a problem that a lot of plants see all the time, especially cocoa growers. Cocoa growers, because they don't have a humic layer and salts just flow out of the cocoa really quickly. Nothing's held on to that in there, right? So the cocoa growers are going to see problems all the time because the minerals are just flushing right out of the cocoa. Some growers are amazing at cocoa. So I think it's just too much maintenance. I don't want a woman like that, right? I want a chill woman, good mom, cook good meal, not paying my ass, not going to constantly be needing my attention. I, in my life, have gotten to a point where I'm not looking for the top shelf club herb. I'm not trying to sell it off at the highest dollar. I'm, for me, just trying to grow something personal for me that's healthy in line with my values. So that's what I always talk about. I can get you to a certain point, but if you want to be like the top shelf cup winners, I definitely recommend you find two or three guys out there that are literally pushing the edge every day. They're going to the clubs because a lot of that stuff is politics too. A lot of people don't realize that. I know they're not supposed to have politics. It should be this and completely anonymous thing, but it is politics. So if you're going to ever want to get into that game, you're going to have to get into the culture of all the people involved with it, especially if you want to get in like the top five ever. If you disagree with me, please leave a comment down below. Okay, next comment. Brandon Davis, wouldn't you want a little calcium in the flowering stage to help the stems harden and support the colas? Yes, 100% you are going to want some additional calcium. You know, obviously, guys, I have to create like a thumbnail that attracts you guys and want to do some clickbait. I mean, I'm learning how to do that, right? So I'm going to do something a little controversy. And if I misspoke in this video, I got to go back and re-listen to it. But I'm trying to get you guys to think about what the plant is doing. What is it doing and how can you assist it using microbiology to enhance the process, right? You know, so you could do what you want to do. If you want to grow 10 footers, 15 footers, grow 15 pounders, you want to keep getting consistent yield, whatever that looks like. I'm just trying to get you to think about what the plant is doing and get out of the frame of mind of this industry. Like, this mindset of this industry is so toxic and it is surrounded by so much greed. You cannot trust what anyone is saying. Don't even trust me, guys. Like, you do your own research, and I'm just trying to give you a perspective outside of what you're going to hear out in this industry because of what I got from my own experience, right? And that's it, you know? And so, yes, you're going to want some calcium. In my viewpoint opinion, you're not definitely not going to need as much calcium. So, like, if you're using biodynamics, well, the microbes are going to take care of the work, right? And so this is when I go into flowering, I'm going to, but my tea though, after week four, and I'm obviously talking like a 9-weeker, 10-weeker, 9-weeker, if it's a 10 or 11 or 12, that it might go as far as into the fifth week, maybe fifth and a half week into flowering or something where the plant really stops stretching and stops growing. At that point, I'm really, my teas are going to be potash based. It's going to be like lignite. I'm going to go through a couple different things. I'll show you right here. The Gaia Green, it'll be the soluble seaweed extract, right? It's the soluble potash, 17%. Over the down to earth, it'll be lignite right here. And this is going to be 0022. Down to earth is US, the US brand. And guys, if you're in the US, support Down to Earth. They're a great freaking company. They have literally been carrying the weight of the dry amendments products in the US for 30 years. Like, support them. Gaia Green's been literally leading the charge in Canada. So guys, if you're in the US, support Down to Earth. You know, you're in the Canadians, go support the Gaia Green. And like I said, your soil should already be amended with amendments like oyster shells or dolomite or gypsum or whatever you're using. There should be amendments that you've already amended your soil with. All I'm talking about specifically, and sorry if I'm not more specific, and that's why we're getting into it now. If you're a synthetic grower or even biodynamics, this is where you're going to start to adjust your nutrients a little bit. And it's three main times you're going to adjust your nutrients. Right when you put your seeds or clones into the ground, when you transition from veg to flower, and when your plants dramatically stop growing and start putting on the flowers. I think these three things, there should be a dramatic adjustment in your feed line. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Have a great grow, everyone. So wouldn't it make sense if you're having a magnesium deficiency, it's a good chance that you might be having a secondary deficiency on some level, right? And right when you start to make these connections, you're like, oh, you know, I'm just not having a magnesium deficiency. I'm also having a phosphorus deficiency, or I'm having a secondary. I'm going to once again explain that more in depth in a second.